So we are now on our module 2 on the MSTE. Okay, so let's begin with this ratio and variations. Okay, so madali lang to. Problem 1, we are required to calculate the x here. We have this ratio, 3 minus x is to x plus 1 is equals to 2 is to 1. So we can rewrite this pag ganito. Okay, I know you can follow na this. And syempre, i-simplify lang natin further para mas mahaba yung solution natin. Or actually, you can do the shift solve na dito. 3x minus 2, and we got this, and we have x as 1/3. Okay? I know you will do the shift solve na dito. Or mas magandang i-practice na lang ito, yung simplification. Malayo pa naman yung board exam nyo. Okay, so here, another example on the ratio and variations. So we have this 3 ratio, x is to y is to z is equals to 2 is to 5 is to 7, and 4x minus y plus 2z is equals to 51. So we are required to calculate x, y, and z. Okay, so ganito yan. So if we have this ratio, ang gagawin ko dito is I will divide this ratio para into the first term. Kumbaga, as you can see, we will divide this whole term dito into 2 para yung first value natin will be a 1 unit. Okay, ito yung technique ko. It depends, baka may comfortable way kayo na in solving this, but for me, ito yung ginagawa ko. Gagawin kong 1 unit yung pinakaunang ratio natin dito. That will be 1. So, we need to divide that by 2. So, magiging ganito siya. Now, take note that we have another equation here. So, how can we calculate that? So, ang ibig sabihin nito sa ratio na ito, that a value of x, that one value of x will correspond to 5/2 of y. This one, that will correspond as 5/2 of y. I mean, y is equals to 5/2 of the x. Okay? And this one naman, that will correspond to the z. And it is ganito. 7, the z is equals to 7/2 of x. Yan yung ibig sabihin dyan. Now, as you can see, we express the y and z into x. Meaning, we can directly substitute these two variables here dito. Okay? As you can see, using this, and ayun, y is 5/2 of x, then z is equals to 7/2 of x. Now, yung x na lang yung matitirang unknown, and x is 6 meters. I know, that is unitless. Okay, that is 6. Now, we will calculate the value of y using this. So, that is 15. That is 5/2 times 6, or times x, that is 15. And yung z naman, that is 7/2 of x, that is 21. And these are the answers. Okay, madali lang. Now, another example. Find the third proportional of 2 and 3. So, ano yung ibig sabihin ng third proportional? So, ganito lang yan. If we have this sequence, 2, 3, then the third sequence, the third proportional will be, let's call that x. Okay, we will just do the ratio and proportion. This is to the preceding or naunang term, 3/2, is equals to the preceding term over the first term. So, x over 3. Okay, ratio and proportion lang. X is to 3 is equals to 3 is to 2. And here, we calculated our x as 9/2. Okay, so madali lang. Napaka-ikli lang ng solution natin. How about ito? Find the mean proportional between 2 and 8. So, how can we solve this? Okay, so actually, the same pa rin. The same approach doon. But, we will use this formula na lang. Okay? X sub n raised to n, ito yung mean proportional, is equals to a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, multiply lang natin lahat. So, in this case, that will be dalawa sila, no? Dalawa. So, that will be x squared is equals to 2 times 8. Yung n is the number of the terms dito. Okay? So, by square root of 2 times 8, that is just 4. Claro? Okay. Or you can just you can just do the ratio portion. Kumbaga, my 2, then my middle term, yung middle term natin, that will correspond to the mean proportion itong dalawa. Okay? Well, anyways, mas maganda ito. Para kung marami na siya, maraming numbers na, diretso na tayo dyan. Okay? Okay, variations tayo. The pressure P of a given mass of ideal gas varies inversely as the volume V and directly as the absolute temperature T. To what pressure must 100 cubic feet of helium at 1 atmosphere pressure and 253 degrees temperature will be subjected to be compressed to 50 cubic feet when temperature is 313 degrees. So, I think alam nyo na to. So, it just simply says that the P varies, sinabi niya, P of a given mass of ideal gas varies inversely as the volume. That means yung volume will be 1, will be nasa ibaba, or kumbaga, that will be 1 over B, inverse, kumbaga. Okay? And directly, meaning nasa itaas. Parang ganito lang yung logic niya. Pag inverse, dapat nasa ibaba, or i-reciprocal natin. Pag directly, no need to reciprocal, diretso na. Okay? As the temperature T, to what pressure of 100 cubic feet of helium at 1 atmosphere the pressure and 253 degrees temperature be subjected to be compressed into, okay, so and so on. Parang, as you can see, you know, this is just the Boyle's law or the property of ideal gas. Okay? Napakita natin to from our hydraulics, no, sa past lecture natin. So it just simply says that we can simplify our equation pag ganito. We have the constant of proportionality K. Okay, so by that we can rearrange that will be PB over T. Now we can we have the givens here. We can rearrange that. So it is that stated that we have 1 atmosphere pressure with a volume of 100 cubic feet. So 1 times 100, that will be PB over T. The temperature is 250 degrees, and that should be equated since we have the constant K naman. So we can equate the K1 to K2. Okay, so I hope you got this. We just equated the constant of proportionality. We have K1 and K2. So, of course, the same formula pa rin. In this case, we will call this P2. Then, our volume 2 daw, sinabi, it will be compressed to 50 cubic feet. So, that will be 50. Then, into when at temperature is 313 degrees. That one divided by 313. Okay, so we can get this 2.47 atmosphere.